Let's all play What's My Line?
Thank you, all bodies. Thank you, and welcome to What's My Line. Won't you be seated, all bodies?
Well, I want to say it's a pleasure, and I want to congratulate you on winning the Tony for your fine performance, and a funny thing happened on the way to the performance.
Thank you very much.
Great show.
Thank you. There was only one way to get a good part, and it was produce the show myself, so I did it. Welcome to What's My Line. During the next 30 minutes, you'll meet some interesting people engaged in occupations, which we hope will baffle our panel. In addition to the panel, they will face a celebrity mystery guest a bit later on. Right now, let's meet our first challenger. Would you enter and sign in, please? Mr. Henry Boyd.
Hi, nice to see you.
Sit down.
Right.
Where are you from, Mr. Boyd?
Sunnyside, Long Island.
Okay, panel. Henry Boyd works in the field of entertainment. He has a specialty. Now let's show the audience just what his specialty is. All right, and we'll start the game with Donna Valeri.
Am I right in assuming that you're not a stripper?
That's right.
He's not a stripper. Is it in the music field?
Sort of, yes.
Well, it more or less is in the broadest possible sense, but I'm afraid it would mislead you to get a yes on a thing like that. So let's have a no, and that'll be one down and nine to go, and Gene will be up.
That means you hum when you work. That's about how broad it is.
Is that a question?
No. Does it sound like a question to you? Sir, no. Mr. Boyd.
Yes.
Are you in the business end of entertainment rather than in the performing end of entertainment?
No.
No, he is not. That's two down and eight to go, Melba.
So you, Mr. Boyd, then actually provide the entertainment through your performance.
That's right.
Would your kind of entertainment be suitable for the entire family, children as well as adults?
Oh, yes, definitely.
You look like a dirty old man.
All right. Is your entertainment seasonal in any way?
Not necessarily.
Not necessarily. So that's three down and seven to go. We go to Soupy.
Mr. Boyd?
Yes.
This act that you do, is it like a novelty act?
Yes.
That means that you work with some particular kind of prop?
No.
Does he work with a prop? No, he does not. That's four down and six
to
go, Donna.
Do you use your lips?
Yes.
But I would say, do you make bird sounds?
Right.
That is correct. Mr. Boyd imitates bird calls and is an authority on bird life. Excuse me, Mr. Boyd, how long have you been doing bird calls?
About 50 years.
And how many bird calls do you do?
I think about 60 songbirds.
Ooh, would you give us a sample?
Certainly. The wood thrush.
Ooh, that's beautiful. That's really beautiful. Soupy, do you do bird calls?
I would do my bird calls today, but I have chapped lips.
I can make the sound of an Italian rooster.
How does that go?
Well, it goes kikiriki. That's Italian roosters go like. They don't go cock-a-doodle-doo or whatever American roosters do.
I thought they just pinched.
Well, let's see how good you all are at recognizing other bird calls. Then, as Henry imitates each call, we'll show the audience just what bird it is. Okay, Soupy, you have a shot at the first one. Okay,
I'll have a shot any time. That's
got
enough,
it?
Henry. I got it.
Does anybody else know what it is?
No.
It's a bob white.
A metropole.
What is it, Henry?
It's a robin.
A robin.
Oh, a robin.
Robin. No.
Okay, let's have another one. Donna, see if you can get this one.
Right. Oh,
that's easy. He's spelling it for you.
A bluebird.
A bluebird. No.
I don't know any names.
It's an American rooster. It's a whippoorwill.
Whippoorwill. Right.
Okay, let's do one more, huh? Gene, you have first shot at this one.
That's the policeman at Fifth Avenue and 57th Street.
What is that one, Henry?
Cuckoo.
It's a cuckoo.
Well, that fit me all right.
Oh. Melba, I bet you get this one.
I bet I don't.
I bet you do.
That sounds like the title of it. Yes, Rinso White Bird.
What is it?
Bob White.
Oh, it's a Bob, Bob White. White. It's a Bob White. Okay, can you do another one for us? See if you can get this one, Soupy. Soupy, you know what it is?
That sounds like a good
That's a little bird, isn't it?
A little bird.
But I don't
know. It's a big rotten bird. It's a blue jay.
Oh, a blue. Oh,
yeah, they're thief birds.
I got one on
here's
my
a little
foot.
Bird. Donna, here's a little bird. Well, no, who else has got it?
Canary.
Canary, right, Melba, it's a canary. Okay, Henry, thank you for being with us on What's My Line. That was just marvelous. Henry Boyd.
All contestants on What's My Line receive these gifts from Sarah Coventry, a handsome golden heirloom locket pendant, Florentine bracelet, and Dady Trilight rings, a charming look of elegance by Sarah Coventry, and Buxton accessories, ladies' trunk and leather fashions for her, buttercalf leather accessories and fashionable new belts for him, all from Buxton, and 12-carat gold-filled cross-writing instruments. The slender, perfectly balanced design and mechanical excellence make cross-writing instruments an international standard. Larry, back to you.
Okay, thank you. We're back. Our next challenger, would you enter, please, and sign in. Madeline Knight.
Hello. Thank you, Brad.
Is it Miss Knight? Miss Knight, where are you from, Miss Knight?
Miami.
Okay, he's from Miami. Panel, we're concerned with a job that Miss Knight no longer holds, but it was a fascinating job. She left it to continue her education, but we thought it was amusing enough and interesting enough for you to have a shot at it. Now, she was in charge of something. We will show the audience what it was that she was in charge of. And let's start the questioning with Jean Shallot.
Is this a job I could have also been fired from?
Oh, I wasn't fired.
No, she wasn't fired.
Oh, you just quit, huh?
I had
a likely story. Well, I'll let you get away with it. Is this a job that I could possibly have held?
Yes.
Is this a job, since the audience left, that involves something very much out of the ordinary?
For me, I guess it would be.
Would I find this job listed in the Yellow Pages?
I guess so.
I would, eh? Well, they have good Yellow Pages.
I tell you, Jean, you might, but it's highly unlikely that you would. So let's have one down and nine to go and move on to Melba.
Did you, were you in charge of something other than other people?
Yes.
Were these things you were in charge of, would they be considered animals?
No.
And
no.
I mean, aside from human animals.
No, they wouldn't. Two down and eight to go. Soupy?
Well, the thing that you were in charge of, was it a, that it would be unlikely that a woman would be in charge?
Yes.
Does it indeed have something to do, like, with a college or a...
No.
No, it has nothing to do with a college at all, depending on where you sit. Dana? Donna?
Let me think. Were you in charge of a place?
Yes.
Was this place, did it have, like a department store type place?
No.
Wrong.
Not like a department store type place. Four down and six to go. Back to Jean.
Miss Knight, there are no people and no, I'm just reviewing, no people and no animals involved in what you had charge of, but you had charge of a place. In other words, you had...
I don't think we established that there were no people involved in it at all, did we?
I thought we did.
That's what Melba asked. Were you in charge of people? And they said no.
We're in charge of people, I see. All right, then we established it to that extent, all right.
You weren't in charge of people, you weren't in charge of animals. Were you in charge of some big empty place, like the Gypsy headquarters?
Is Gypsy headquarters a specific question you're asking?
No, I want to know whether or not you were in charge of an empty location, a sort of a caretaker job, while there was no animal and no person around.
As a caretaker, more or less. We'll give a yes on that, Gene,
yeah.
Okay?
You took care of this in the daytime rather than nighttime?
Yes.
Did this have anything to do with politics?
No.
Nothing at all. $5.05 to go, Melba.
What singer of a question. And it was a place that you took care of, or whatever it was, during the day. In being in charge of this, whatever you were in charge of, did you work mainly out of doors?
Yes.
You did. Did you have to wear something other than you're wearing now to perform
yes.
your job? You wore a uniform of some sort. Was it a uniform that identifies you immediately with a group of people, like a Playboy bunny or a policeman or something of that
yes.
sort?
Yes.
It's a nice combination.
Was it a brief outfit?
It was not a brief outfit. Let's try 15 more seconds. Soupy, what do you say? 6 down, 4 to go. You have any idea?
When you do this thing, it wouldn't be in a cemetery, would it?
That's what I thought.
No,
it's not in a cemetery. Donna?
That's what I thought, for a cemetery.
No, it wasn't a cemetery.
Wasn't.
I tell you what, we'll flip them all over because you have an idea, Melba?
Is it something that had to do with sports that maybe you were?
No.
No, it didn't. She was in charge of the Dade County garbage dump.
How come I got a no answer on politics?
She was a first dump attendant for the Dade County Waste Department, the first woman to be hired by them. How did you get that job, Madeline?
I fought for it.
You fought? How?
Well, they didn't want any women working there, so I went to Civil Liberties Union, and they called them up and said, well, listen, we think we've got a good case for court here. So I went back and I told them what the Civil Liberties Union said, and they said, no, let's send her over to the waste department. Maybe we can get rid of her that way. And it turned out that I liked the job at the dump really well.
Why was that? Do people throw away unusual things? I mean, what do they throw in there?
Well, they throw out everything, you know.
Lines.
There was a boat out there. And
boat?
I collected enough really nice furniture to fill up my room. Antiques.
Yeah, but you should see her icebox.
Someone threw out a solid oak table, you know, coffee table.
What did you have to do, really? Did you just stand there while people came and dumped their
I'd help
garbage?
Them unload and sweep up.
Directed the flies.
Listen, Madeline, we have to push ahead, but thank you very much for being with us on What's My Line.
That's lovely.
It's time now to play Who's Who, so could we have the curtain open, please? Now here, panel, you see 4 people from the studio audience and a list of their actual occupations. One is a writer, one sells jewelry, one is a teacher, and one is a stationary engineer. All you have to do, panel, is to hand out all 4 cards so that each person is holding the card which represents his actual occupation. Let's start with Soupy, and you have 20 seconds. Go. Soupy, you are correct. Terrific. That is terrific. Okay, everyone, will you tell us who's who?
I am Pat Brunson, and I am a writer.
My name is Tony Lando, and I sell jewelry.
I'm Joyce Levins, and I'm a teacher.
I'm Fred Iris, and I'm a stationary engineer.
That's terrific. You didn't fool anyone, but each member of the team will receive a gift. Thanks for playing Who's Who on What's My Line. Thank you very much. Okay, now, panel, you're putting your blindfolds on. Gene, I don't think you are.
Just once, but I have a little edge.
No. Blindfolds on. Are they all in place? Okay, will our mystery guest enter and sign in, please? Well, mystery guest, I recognize you, but I've never seen you with glasses on before. Why are you wearing them?
Well, I'll tell you something, Larry. With the kind of summer we had back east here, I wanted to come prepared. Get a close-up of this, Charlie.
Okay. Okay, panel, it's one question at a time now. We'll give you 3 minutes to establish the identity of our mystery guest, and we'll start the questioning with Melba Tolliver.
I think you tried to throw us off with that bit about the glasses, Larry. Our guest doesn't wear glasses. But did I understand you to say that you are now on the West Coast, or living now on the West Coast?
Well, I live a little bit everywhere. I'm a traveler.
Are you known primarily for your work?
Well, one question at a time, so we move on to Soupy. Soup?
Are you currently appearing in a vehicle in town? I mean, not a cab. But, no, I mean, are you in a show that's playing on Broadway?
No, not at the present, but I think I'm going to make a sequel to The Godfather, and since I'm a sissy, we're going to call it The Godmother.
Hey, Donna?
Do we know you from your appearances on television?
Well, all depends on what kind of memory you got, baby.
In what, partly, Gene?
Are you currently playing in a movie in New York City?
No, not currently. I made a movie, but they kept the movie and released me.
Okay, two down and one to go. Melba? Gene, I'm sorry. Gene?
No, I just asked.
You did? You asked that? Melba.
It sounded like Melba.
It sounded like me.
Yeah.
Are you currently appearing in production off Broadway?
No, I'm not currently appearing any place, baby.
Three down and seven to go, Sue.
Gee, we both have the same agents. no, then you mentioned something. Did you once have your own television show?
Yeah, I once had my own television show.
Donna?
You make a couple of more cracks like that, and I'm going to give you a contract you can't refuse.
Donna?
Do you sing? With a voice like that, how can you say no?
Do I sing?
Well, he isn't really known as a singer, I wouldn't say.
Not known as a singer, not like Sergio Franchi, no.
Four down and six to go, Gene.
Wow. I am really stuck. The man doesn't work.
I think he's got everybody fooled. He's really very good at this.
It's probably a girl.
Let's flip them all over, take off the blindfolds, and meet Peter Lynn Hayes. Peter is really living in Las Vegas now with his wife, actress Mary Healy, and he's just here for a visit.
We have a lot of fond memories together because Larry and I were in Who Was That Lady I Saw You With, and I want to congratulate you on the tremendous success of On My Way to Decorum or something like that.
Close enough for jazz. It was a delight working with him, I must tell you. He was marvelous. One night we had a snowstorm in Philadelphia, and the audience was coming down the aisles at us, and Peter blanched. And I said, "What's the matter, Peter? Why are you? What happened to you in the scene?" He said, "I'm from nightclubs, and when they come down the aisles after you, they're coming for you." Didn't something happen to you like that once, Peter?
Yeah, we were held up at the Mounds Club in Cleveland by 14 men who stayed 45 minutes. That's the kind of people we used to draw in supper clubs, and that's why we're out of them now.
What are you doing now, Peter? Are you retired, or are you just...
We're sort of semi-retired and refer to ourselves as Ma and Pa Kettle of Las Vegas, and we live in Westchester 5 months a year and 7 months a year in Las Vegas, and our son just got married, and our daughter's about to get married, and how are your children?
They're doing all right. You want them?
What's your address?
You still got your tugboat?
No, I sold the tugboat, Gene. I watch you, though, in Las Vegas, and I think you're terribly clever. And
oh, you almost stopped there.
I remember you for a long time, too, before you grew the handlebars.
Peter, what happened with the radio show? Are you going to do another one of those, or have you decided not to do it?
No, they got wise to us, and so we... Actually, it was wonderful for us for 6 years on WOR here locally because it gave us those traumatic years with our teenagers. But they're all grown now, and happily, I think everything's going to work out. Our son just went to work in systems engineering over at CBS.
That's terrific,
remember
Peter.
Him,
you're looking
baby buggy.
Yes, I do. And you're, let's thank you for coming and
he's
meeting with us.
He's 6'4", and I'm 4'6".
Okay, thanks, Peter.
Oh, mercy.
What's My Line continues right after this word. Panel, you did beautifully today. You bat 333. Maybe we can fool you better tomorrow. In the meantime, goodbye, ladies and gentlemen. And don't forget to be with us every day on What's My Line. Goodbye.
This is Dennis Hoadley speaking for What's My Line, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.